You gotta have an organization that allows fun to flourish. And here are some examples of fun in our hotel. Ladies and gentlemen, in order for fun to truly be in an organization, it has to be a part of the culture. Definitions, activities, rituals, symbols, celebrations, all of those things have to be created, all right, with the blessing of leadership. We got to make it legitimate. It's okay to have a good time. Recognizing that a fun place to work is where people are going to wake up and look forward to come every day. Take the fear out of responsible fun. It's all right. We look at every activity in our hotels and we say, how can we inject a little bit of fun in that? So examples of fun in our hotels are, okay, we have leader outings. Every quarter, believe it or not, we do this because our business can be extremely stressful, just like any other organization. So what we do is we set up either bowling activities, we go fishing, or we bring in folks to teach dance lessons, a casino night, go to the theme parks, as we have a few, okay? Whatever we want to do, we do. And it's all about allowing our leaders to network with each other, to understand how we can support each other well. It's really an awesome time for folks to let their hair down and truly get to know each other better. We also have star rallies. Now, this is the meeting like you're having right now, but our rallies are a little different. It's our general manager giving information to everybody in the hotel. We have film crews that'll go around and film folks doing some silly things before the rally. And then once you all come in, those videos are playing. And here's an example of what that looks like.
Take a look at this.
I slope in my bloody by the sun. Now orange and white and red, green and yellow. Rainbow colors, tonight I see the view. Slip as I go through.
Boink, boink, baby. That's good stuff.
Everything bright, your song burning shoes. The look in your eyes, think of bones into
love. Scurry, we don't know.
Yon spoke a little bit about the records in our score.
The first one is guest satisfaction, and our goal is to be at 70%.
Flex space of about 40,000 square feet. And I'm backing you up.
This culture is just as important to you all as it is to me, and thank you for that.
We are here today to present Gaylord's top.
I've been through your sleeve, bursting through the.
You, the stars, nominate your co-stars for the 7 Gaylord Values.
My favorite part.
The boots with the zipper.
RGM.
All right, let's have fun.
In March, we earn 7. Guests will return all. A bonus, you will earn all!
We continue to take care of our stars. They provide flawless service. That creates customer satisfaction, which creates guest loyalty, which at the end of the day drives profitability for our company.
That's right, I'll tell you why. Because we have you!
Whatever.
Are you Director of Entertainment. And that's how we have our meetings, where we actually give information to our folks, and all of our properties do it that way. It's a production, ladies and gentlemen. Now, celebrations, promotion celebrations. When somebody gets promoted in our company, they have to ride the rickshaw. The department leader from that department gets on the bike and rides them around the hotel, and everybody in the department follows with bells and whistles. It's the most embarrassing thing I've ever gone through. But we do it. Star sports leagues. We have the football. We got basketball. We have all the leagues all the other hotels want to participate within the area. And we do it better than anybody. We want to compete and be the best in city in everything. So why not in sports as well? Family events. This is my favorite. We do movie nights. We do family time at the pools, where we allow our stars to bring their family into our pool area and have a good time with hot dogs, hamburgers, and things of that nature. But my favorite is bring your sons and daughters to work day. I have been doing the sons and daughters to work for the last, I think, 10 years, and watch folks' kids just grow up to the point we allow them to come from 6 to 13. The 14 and 15-year-olds are still trying to sneak into this event, okay? It's so much fun. They get to work in some of the departments. They get to go in the culinary department and make pastries and things of this nature. They have a great time. And one of our events, we actually taught them to do a flash mob. And when they had dinner with their parents, they all stood up and did this flash mob, totally blowing their parents away, not realizing that was coming. Spontaneous fun, like I said, whatever we can do, wherever we can make it happen, we want to do that because we want our place to be an outstanding place for people to come every day. Ovations. We do star ovations for new people coming in. This particular ovation was for our hotel manager. And when he came in for the first time, we held up signs to let him know that we're so happy that he's there. We do this for clients that we're trying to sell the business to. When they walk through the door, as many people as we can get in the hallway, let them know that we want their business. And if they come, they're going to feel what they're feeling as they're walking through that line. So star ovations are very important. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in keeping up with the fun factor, really quick, I need about 15 volunteers to come forward. Come on. I'm going to teach you something that is the theme dance at all of our properties, especially the Gala Palms. All right, I got a few. So what we're going to do is line up here. A couple of people can come up on stage. Oh, come on. I know there's more people out there that like to have fun here in UMass. That's what I'm talking about. You can stand right there. If some of you want to stand in the aisles, here's what's going to happen. Oh, this is looking good. Looking good. You can stay down there. That's good. All right. So I'm going to teach you what we're going to do. Okay. This is a four count movement, and it's easy, y'all. It's really easy. Are you ready for this now? Four count movement. We're going to go to the right. Four steps. Ready? One, two, three, four. Now to the left. One, two, three, four. Stop. Now with your right leg, we're going to kick. Four times. Ready? Right, left, right. Okay, here we go. One, two, three, four. Stop. Now, here's the last move. You're going to turn on a four count movement. One, two, three, four. All right, everybody got that? So we're going to go to the right, to the left, kick four times, turn four times. Everybody ready? It's called the what? It's called the Cupid Shuffle. Hit the music.
New Cupid, new Cupid.
All right, now listen. When I tell you to go, you're going to go. You ready? All right, everybody warm up.
Change.
Warm up. All right. All right, get ready now. Here we go.
New style. One, down to
two,
the dance.
Three,
we got a brand
four.
New dance.
One, down two, to three, four.
Let's
get
the swing on. Three, four.
Turn
down
to the
dance.
Three, four.
And I say no. They say what
y'all.
You doing, trying to do
right,
somebody
go.
I just let the music come from my soul.
Enter.
So all of my
oh,
people can stay
good.
On the floor.
All
they
right.
Got
show you how
Let's
it goes.
To the right.
Now walk it by yourself. Now walk it by yourself.